test for equality for two variances. F test for equality of two variances. F test is used to test if the variance of the two populations are same. Okay, the F test is used to the variance of two populations are same. That is, F test assume that the variances, that is, the samples come from the same population, that they are normally distributed. Okay, in this, this can be two types. One is two-tail test. Second one is one-tail test. The two-tail test version against the alternative that, okay, the two variances are not equal. When coming to the one-tail test, against this alternative, only one direction we are going to verify. So, two-tail test, the variance of the two populations are not equal. Against that, variance of the populations are not equal. In the one-tail test, we are going to be using only one direction. Okay? So, this choice is determined by the problem. This choice is can using one-tail test or two-tail test. So, this is determined by the problem. Okay? Next, test of hypothesis. Define as, test of hypothesis defined as, first one is null hypothesis, that is H0 means, so the variances are equal. For example, if you go to take the two samples, sample 1 A, sample B 2, so variance of this sample is S1 squared, the variance of the sample is S2 squared. Whether we are going to verify the differences between the two samples are significant. What it means? We are going to verify the differences between two samples are significant. That means the first one is null hypothesis. You can define, assume the null hypothesis. That means there is no difference between the sample variances. That is S1 squared is equal to S2 squared. So first you have to define the null hypothesis. Let us second one is alternative hypothesis. That means H1. Alternative hypothesis means, okay, completely okay, opposite of the H0, null hypothesis. That means, so first one is H1 is not equal to S2. Why? It is related to two types. The second one is H1, S1 square is greater than S2 squared. Or S1 square is less than S2 squared. These two are related to one-tail test. One-tail test, two-tail test. The third one is to find the level of significance, LOS, or under the alpha value. Okay, so we are going to identify the alpha value at 5% level, 1% level, or 0.1% level. The table values are given only for 5%, 1% or 0.1% only. So, you can see the table value at alpha under the degrees of freedom, nu1, comma, nu2. So, where nu1 is equal to n1 minus 1, nu2 is equal to n2 minus 1. Okay? So, first one is define the null hypothesis. Second one is write the alternative hypothesis based on the null hypothesis. Third one is identify the table value at the level of confidence, okay, alpha, under the degrees of freedom, nu1 and nu2, okay, where nu1 is equal to n1 minus 1, nu2 is equal to n2 minus 1. So, these are the first three steps. Then, go to fourth one, test statistics. That means, F is equal to S1 squared by S2 squared. Okay, if S1 squared is greater than S2 squared, okay, R, S2 squared by S1 squared. If S1 squared is greater than S2 squared. Okay, so we are going to use the formula for finding the test statistics. F4 is equal to S1 squared by S2 squared. If S1 squared is greater than S2 squared. Or S2 squared is greater than S2 squared is greater than S1 squared. Okay, this is the formula for finding the statistics value. So finally, conclusion will be established. Conclusion means, okay, is less than table value. Table value we calculate in the third step. So we are finding the table value by using the alpha and u1 u2. So okay, then calculator value is by the fourth step we are getting the calculator value. We will go to combine the calculator value and table value. Okay, when calculator value is less than table value, then h naught is accepted. What is h naught is? There is no difference between the two variances. If calculator value is more than the table value, then h naught is rejected. That means all the hypotheses is accepted. So when you are using the two type test, then all the hypotheses is not equal. But in one type test, more than or less than. Okay, this is the process to identify the test statistics method.
Okay, now we are going to get the problems on the test. Okay, problem. The measurements of the output of two units have given the following results, assuming that both samples have been obtained from the normal population at 10% significance level. The test whether the two population have the same variances. What is the question? So test whether the two population have the same variances. That means you have to verify the variance of the two populations are same. That means for verifying we are going to using F test problem. Okay, come on. Problem now. Unit A, unit B. Unit A values 3.1, 10.1, 15.7, 13.7, 14.0. Unit B values 14.5, 13.7, 12.7, 14.1. So these samples are taken from the two populations. Okay, so now we are going to verify whether the two variance of the two populations are same. Okay, na? So come on. So before going to verify the condition, okay, now first one is, so here we are going to verify the values S1 square and S2 square values. We are going to identify first S1 square, S2 square. What is the S1 square formula? 1 by N1 minus 1 into summation of xi minus x bar whole square. Next, S2 square equal to 1 by n minus n2 minus 1 into summation of yi minus y bar whole square. Where n1, number of independent attributes in the first sample, n2, number of attributes in the second sample, x bar, mean of the first sample, y bar, mean of the second sample. Okay, coming here. So, find the n1 value, number of independent attributes, values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, n2, there also 5 values are given. Then go to find the x bar. The mean of x bar given is mean of the first sample. So mean of the sample is the formula. Sum of the values by number of the values. Sum of the values means sum of these values by number of values. Sum of these is equal to 66.6 by number of values 5. It will be equal to 30.32. Okay, then y bar. Y is indicated the second sample variables. So then calculate y bar value. Y bar equal sum of yi by n2. Sum of yi means sum of these values by number of the values. The 16 by 5 is equal to 13.8. So first we are finding x bar and y bar. Sample first sample mean, second sample mean. Then coming to next one is, so to find the values of all the values of the samples. Okay, x. So that means the values of the first sample. So then find the taking difference between the x and x bar. What is x bar is 13.32. x means the following value, taking the differences between the values. Then after that, taking square. Okay, this is x minus x bar whole square. Then similarly, not only y value, and find the y minus y bar value, then go to taking square and, okay, of these terms. So this is. So we calculate sum of xi minus x bar whole square, then sum of y bar whole square value. It is x minus x bar whole square value, y minus y bar whole square value. Then what x is? To identify the variances of the two samples. So first sample here is formula. 1 by n1 minus 1 summation of x minus x bar whole square. What is the summation value? 13.488. By n1, number of entries in the sample, 5 minus 1, 4. Then dividing by 4, then is equal to 3.488. Similarly, you have to find S2 square. S2 square means variance of variance of the second sample. Same formula, 1 by n2 minus 1, sum of yi minus y bar whole square. What is the summation of yi minus y bar whole square? 1.84. Then dividing by n2 minus 1, n2 means number of values in the second sample. 5 sample is given, 5 minus 1 4, then dividing, then it is getting 0.46. okay, so here we go to observe the variance of the first sample is less greater than the variance of the second sample. This is the very very important, so you have to observe this one. So it is very important to find the test statistics value. Okay, test statistics is to are very important. So the difference is very important. So here S1 score is more than the S2 square. Okay, so S1 square value is 3.372 and S2 square value is 0.46. So here S1 square value is more than the S2 square. Okay, so before verifying the test of hypothesis, so you can calculate variance of the first sample and second sample. Okay, then coming next, test statistics is defined as, first one is to identify the write the null hypothesis. Okay, null hypothesis means H naught. Okay, assuming that there is no differences between the variances of the two population, that means variance is S first sample variance is S1 square, second sample variance is S2 square. So S1 square is equal to S2 square. Now go to next second one is, let us assume ordinate hypothesis. Okay, now the samples are not equal. Not equal means, so we are going to be using two type test. Okay, so they are not equal means, maybe S1 more than the S2 square or S2 square is more than the S1 square. Okay, so now go to identify the LOS, level of significance. Okay, under the degrees of freedom. So okay, the number of independent values in the first sample 5, number of independent values in the second sample 5. Okay, na? So now go to see the table value. Under the degrees of freedom, n1 minus 1 comma n2 minus 1. So n1 minus 1 comma n2 minus 1. So but one more thing is coming here, s1 square is greater than to s2 square. Then you can see the table value under the degrees of freedom. N1 minus 1 comma N2 minus 1. If in case, if S2 square is greater than S1 square, you can see the table value under the degrees of freedom. Okay, N2 minus 1 comma N1 minus 1. Okay, at alpha value. So table values are available. Okay, 5%, 1%, 0.1%. But in this problem is asking the level of significance at 10%. It means it is nearly equal to the 5%. So that you can see the table value under the degrees of freedom. Okay, 4 comma 4 at alpha value 10 is nothing but 0.5%. Okay, if you go to observe, so okay, along the vertical, we are going to take in n1 values, n1 values, u1 values, along the horizontally, okay, n2 values. Okay, see the table value 4 underscore corresponding. So table value is 6.39. Table value is 6.39. So then observe this one. So see the alpha value. But so this is the table value under the degrees of freedom. N1 minus 1 comma N2 minus 1. N1 is comma U1 U2. So U1 taken as okay horizontally. U2 is taken as vertically. See the table value corresponding N1 U1 and U2 at alpha value 10%. 10% value is not available. It is nothing but is you can see table value under 5%. And the 5% value is 6.39. Okay, this is the table value. So then go to the test statistics. So we have two formulas. One is S1 square by S2 square. Another one is S2 square by S1 square. But then coming to here, so S1 square is more than the S2 square. So that can follow this condition for test statistics. S1 square value. S1 means first sample variance. S2 means second sample variance. By dividing this, get getting 7.33. This is the calculator value. This is the table value. So then you have to calculate them. So okay, the calculator value is less than to the table value. Sorry, table value is greater than to the calculator value. That means, okay, calculator value is more than table value. So that H0 is rejected. Okay, when you are going to reject in the statement, calculator value is more than to the table value. Suppose if calculator value is less than the table value, then you can accept the null hypothesis. But in this case, this problem is calculator value is more than the table value. This is the calculator, this is the table value. So that H0 is rejected. That means automatically H1 is accepted. What is H1? Okay, S1 square is not equal to S2 square. That means significant difference between the variance. There is a some difference. Significance is there. That means difference is some differences are between two samples. Okay, this is the problem. Thank you.